Welcome to Achmar Airfield near Osnabrück in Northwest Germany. We have a sunny day with some 5 meters per second or so of western wind and some cirrus clouds in the sky. And we have 10 pilots getting ready for the 3 flyoffs. Although, as you can see, this place is quite nice and wide and open, we have a few restrictions. So we can't fly to the north, which is active runway with the sailplanes flying all day, both aerotow and winch. So this is a no-fly zone. Then to the south, it's a nature preserve area, and we can't fly there either to disturb the birds or something. So luckily we had wind from east yesterday and from west today, and we can fly in this narrow strip of airspace. So planes are now going everywhere. In the qualifying rounds today, most of the good air was found just to the south of the corridor. The first tree line behind the camp, there were some rotors behind, but some decently good thermals in front. And similarly, there's this patch of grass cut here behind the tree line, and then the next tree line is forming some vertical air movements downwind of the corridor again. So no one is low, as I kind of expected. The lowest planes we have are now there. Wind has increased for this afternoon flyoff. In the morning it was still possible to fly, mid-air. One wingtip flying away. And again, plane without half a wing, still quite controllable. Morning, it was still possible to fly with the lightest planes without much ballast, despite the wind. And now wind has increased, so most of the pilots in the flyoff switched their models for the heaviest ones or added some ballast. Because this was quite a rare strategy in the morning to actually fly downwind, although for me it makes the most sense. But with the light model, it's quite difficult to come back to the landing point. So if you have some ballast, you have more kinetic energy, you can move into the wind a bit better. Also, when you're downwind, you're much more able to see where the air is good and steer your plane accordingly. So it looks like all of the planes down there are at safe heights, no issue whatsoever. And there's one lone guy who decided to go back upwind. Not sure why. Let me see if I can zoom in on him. Looks like he decided to look for his own thermal to avoid the stress of flying in a densely populated airspace. So if you could hear the noise behind me, that was the winch lifting of a sailplane. And as far as our planes are concerned, I think I have only the landings left to take a video of. Minutes till the end of the first flight, and planes are now mostly back, although still very high. Another wind gust. Interesting. Now compare this to the landings we saw in Trnava. Now we'll have a refly. That's why I moved to other side of the field. I expect some risky and low level action here on the trees. Let's see if I was right. Looks like people are going behind the tree line. No one is going in front of the trees. again, really spread, can't really focus on anyone. So let's see what will happen in this group here. Looks like the guys back here have a decent air, they're climbing steadily, but there's someone here in the front who is much closer to the trees. And from this angle, he's pretty much on top of the trees. So he's slightly behind as well. That's why it looked like he dived behind the treetops. But even now, looked quite interesting, I would say. Let's see if he comes out on the other side. He did. Someone running. That's not a good sight. Looks like some people did end up on the trees, which was not really necessary since this is a refly and they already have a result. But meanwhile, the group here to my right dispersed. I see one plane in the distance. One more joining him from below. They are pretty far, but not yet at a safe height. I see three other planes that are in the safe height. People still have to work a bit to earn the relaxing flight back towards the landing point. Looks like he decided to return into the wind from this low height. Let's see how this works out. every time when you're in a pinch, there aren't as many thermals as you would like. So this now again is a bit of a challenge. I can't see what's happening behind the trees. I know there's a gap. No, it looks like he's trying to do something in that gap behind those the first trees. Let's see if he makes it. See him, but I see someone returning with his plane, so at least he didn't end up high in a tree somewhere. I see four planes high in the sky. I'm not sure where the others are. Looks like a few of them are on the ground. Which makes me think that the next start, pilots will be more cautious. Let's go and try the landings now. Looks like only four pilots remained in the air till the end. They have about 1:40 still to do. And this is used for the preparation of landing. Okay, this was the refly. Now let's see if everyone managed to get their planes off the trees. And we continue with the second fly-off. Second start. The third view angle. Ten seconds. So let's see how low will they go now. Here I'll definitely be able to see much better what's happening over the trees. Although it's not in the best angle to the sun. But now I see how far in the distance downwind the planes are. For example, most of the group is here, but there is Tomasz Wrak, a Polish pilot, who is much further downwind than the rest. At similar height. So this will be an interesting comparison. Now it looks like no one is really gaining much. There's someone there already in trouble. But still persisting. Fighting to the end. Even in the close proximity to the trees, which is just inviting trouble. Like he's ready to give up, but no. He doesn't have any other option but to give up. Still, he gained a minute or two with that. A few more turns. And let's hope he'll at least make it to the point. Almost. So what's happening in the meantime? Planes high. Definitely higher than before. But now looks like Wrak is the lowest, but still I think high enough to not be in any trouble. Yeah, his plane has a distinctive and easy to recognize color pattern on the upper wing surface. I can tell who's flying which plane. You see other planes further downwind already and also much higher. And 10 minutes of flying to do still. No, I see some tree breaking noises there. Still guys are trying to get one of the planes out of the branches. Now something fell down. Hope it's not too damaged. One minute till the end of the second flight. Again, the wind is increasing in gusts. The planes are already overhead. So now they won't really need to fly downwind because they need to land on the spot. And with the wind increasing, they will stay close on landing. Landing very close to the spot. Okay, one more flight and let's see who wins this. This thing is excellent flight with some eggs. But careful, only pick the ones that grow out on the meadows. It's very similar looking mushroom that grows in the forest. It's very poisonous. So hopefully the last start. Again from downwind and behind the line. Let's observe again what happens on the tree line. This time there's no one going far downwind from the start, but there's one plane I saw that went upwind. Interesting. But again, the whole group is spread really far out. Hard to even say who's the lowest, but let's pick this guy here. Doesn't look all that good for anyone. low height now above the field than above the trees. Much less risk of having to end your day with some tree climbing. Still, someone looks very eager to end in the trees again. I hope he's far enough behind them to be in the open. Who is that? So he managed to cross over to the open. Looks like it's Frak. This is now very unhelpful position. You either need to risk it all or decide to go back and get at least the points you have so far. But since these are fly-offs and the best pilots, they will risk, of course. So there are two planes now, pretty far and low. And I wouldn't want to be any of them. There's a Frak to the right, don't know who's far in the distance to the left. I think at least he is now in front of the trees. It's hard to judge that from the distance, so... Very difficult. I think he now ended somewhere behind that Jägerstuhl. Still, there's someone really far out. I don't even see him anymore. Here. Flying this way requires, I don't know, guts, balls, whatever you want to say. And also some walking down the field. So in the meantime, people are returning. Looks like it's already late enough in the day so the thermals are dying or something. Or not enough heat from the sun is coming through the clouds to warm up the faster moving air. So looks like it will be the one who comes back to the point that will win this flight. This means you also have to stay in the air for as long as possible and also be able to come back. Aligned here so well with this wind direction as they were in Trnava, so looks like it is possible to hang on the wave from the trees here, but not as easy as it was in Trnava. Also the wind speed is not so constant. There are gusts. If you're not careful, you're blown away. Anyone else still flying? No. No. I think no one is flying anymore. There is still 5 minutes to go. Interesting. So, people either wanted too much or misread the change in the air.
So, hallo ihr Lieben, und dieses Wochenende haben wir erfolgreich hinter uns gebracht. Ich hoffe, euch hat es gefallen und es war alles soweit gut. Freihof hatten wir ja noch so ein bisschen Trubel, weil die Piloten ja so hohes Risiko eingegangen sind. Aber alle sind wieder heilig hier. Nicht die Flugzeuge, aber die Piloten zu. Also, als erstes möchte ich mich mal bei dem veranstaltenden Verein hier bedanken. Für die Zeitnehmer, die einen tollen Job gemacht haben hier 2 Tage. Für die Damen und Herren vom Grill natürlich auch. Ich denke, ihr seht das genauso. Wir sind hier abends und über Tag immer sehr gut bewirtet worden. Mal einen Applaus für den Verein. Dann möchte ich mich bei der Familie Kress bedanken und bei der Silvia, die uns unterstützt haben bei der Auswertung. Dann vielen Dank an die Cheryl Zimmer und ihre Mutter Silvi, die aus Luxemburg gekommen sind, haben hier dieses Display mitgebracht und uns besucht. Ja. Und dann würde ich sagen, kommen wir mal zur Platzierung. Direkt nach dieser Platzierung wird der Uwe Weiß noch die Siegerehrung für die Contest Eurotour durchführen. Da sind auch einige Piloten von mir. Dann würde ich sagen, starten wir mal mit der... Ja, alles klar. Entschuldigung, ich gebe mal weiter.
Ja, ich muss euch noch einen kleinen Moment auf die Vorder spannen, aber nicht ganz. Also, für uns als MFC Osnabrück, das ist die JCAP ausrichten durften. Es hat uns natürlich helfermäßig auch etwas an die Grenzen geführt. Es war schon außergewöhnlich von meiner Seite an unsere Leute. Also auch ein herzlicher Dank an das ganze Organisationsteam, unseren Forsten insbesondere, Hermann und wie sie alle heißen, die hervorragend mitgezogen an diesen Wochen, sodass wir diesen Cup in dieser Weise gewinnen konnten. Das war ganz hervorragend. Ja. Natürlich auch ein herzlicher Dank an euch, an Kevin, an Manu. Ihr habt das auch ganz toll und sehr professionell entwickelt. Ich fand das super interessant, wie das Ganze abgelaufen ist. Also auch dafür herzlichen Dank. Das war, wie es da oben steht, ein Delfin vom Feinsten, ich würde sogar sagen vom Allerfeinsten. Und ja, eine ganz tolle insgesamt runde Veranstaltung. Wer weiß, unter Umständen werden wir das irgendwann mal wiederholen. Aber das muss ich nicht. Vielen Dank.
So, dann würde ich sagen, wir beginnen mit Platz 10. Jan Schwärmer.
haben da auch ein Podest. Das ist ja der
Hauptsache. Wieder mal aufs Podest, die Jungen.
Auch die für die Jugend. Ja, das ist doch.
Das nächste.
Am Suchen Frühgang.
Mache ich denke einfach mal schnell, weil wir haben leider nicht viel aus der Top 10 heute hier. Danke zu den Siegern. Wir haben leider nicht viele von der Top 10 hier. Deswegen lese ich mal nur die ersten drei Jugendlichen vor. Die bekommen einen 11 DLG, die sind aber leider nicht rechtzeitig eingetroffen. Deswegen werden wir nachgeschickt. Ich habe heute auch noch was geändert durch den Wettbewerb hier. Wir haben auf Platz 3 David Gerrit Straff aus Slowenien. Der ist heute leider nicht da. Platz 2 ist aber heute da, der hat sich noch nach vorne geschoben, ist der Jaroslav Ostrel. Bravo! Und der Sieger kommt aus Frankreich, ist leider auch heute nicht da. Der hat dieses Jahr Wander sehr gut geflogen, ist auch bei der Erwachsenen noch ganz vorne dabei, das ist der Adrian. Ja, genau, 105,2 Punkte zu benötigen. Ja, bei den Senioren beschränke ich auch auf die ersten 5, weil dann war zwei davon hier, die kommen links, kommt man das Video aus der Platz 5 aus Polen, Thomas Frank. Wir haben auf Platz 4 305,12 Punkte, auf Platz 3 305,17 und auf Platz 2 305,20. Und Platz 4 ist Adrien Gallet aus Frankreich, ein gutes Pilot. Platz 3, heute noch weit nach vorne gesprungen, Platz 4 auf 3, der Sieger heute, Timo Lust.
Ich bin ja auch
super Spitzner aus Slowenien, aber leider nicht hier.
Soll ich mitnehmen?
Alles klar, danke für die Grüße. Ja, und der Sieger ist Europameister geworden, Weltmeister und jetzt auch heute ist Gesamtsieger. Wahrscheinlich kann er wirklich fliegen. Adrian Zaljuk aus Kroatien. Er hat es geschafft mit der Maximalpunktzahl, die wirklich ist 309 Punkte. Dementsprechend auch relativ.